Hey savvy people, it's Savvy Nick here, and today we'll be installing a beautiful XMonad setup. Let's take a quick look at what we'll have when we're finished installing today. Now this here is the beautiful setup. As you can see, it looks absolutely stunning, especially for a window manager, so it doesn't have quite the footprint of a full-fledged desktop environment, yet it could probably even be used as one. I want to congratulate Arva for the wonderful customized XMonad setup that you see right here, and if you want to be a part of that community, I'll put the Discord channel link in the description below. All right, and we'll jump right in. I'm at my home folder right now, so if I type pwd, I'm in home, Savvy Nick, whatever your user is. We'll start working on this from the home directory. First, I want to get a few packages, so I'm going to type sudo pacman space dash syu space base dash devel development, the git package, vim package, and the crony package. You might already have some of these, not a big deal. Press enter to start installing. I'll put my password in and things will start going here. As far as the selection goes, I'll go for default on all, just enter. And I'm asked if I want to take up some space on my storage disk. I will. The default's yes. I'll press enter. Now, if you need help setting up Arch Linux in order to get it to a state where you can follow along right where I'm at, I do have a video that I'll post in the description below as well as up above. So make sure to check that one out if you're having trouble installing Arch. Continuing on, we'll need a few more packages. I'll clear things out real quick so we have a clean screen. And let's install the Xorg server. We'll do that by typing sudo pacman space dash syu space xorg. This will pull down all the packages related to xorg, and then we'll do libx11 as well. If you do want to go lighter by specifying individual packages and you're confident you can do so, because not all the xorg apps in this xorg package group are necessary, but this will make things easier if you don't mind using a little bit of extra space. I'll press enter and let things go. Again, we're asked if we want the defaults. We can see all the various different xorg packages that are going to be installed on our machine. That's fine. And then I'm going to press enter one again to proceed with the installation. And if you're new and stopping by, make sure to subscribe below and hit that notification bell for more Linux and programming videos. Next, you'll want to make sure to have proper drivers installed for your graphics or video card. That way, you can get the full experience from your hardware. For me, since I'm using NVIDIA graphics, I'll need the NVIDIA proprietary graphics drivers. I'll make sure to add a link below so you can search for other drivers if you have a different brand of card, perhaps integrated Intel or AMD. There's also packages for those as well if you have a different brand of card. Also, there are open source drivers if you prefer to use those, but for NVIDIA, there's really no other choice since the open source version just doesn't stack up. So for that, I will clear things out and do sudo pacman space syu space NVIDIA. I'll also grab the NVIDIA dash utils for utilities and the NVIDIA dash settings for myself. Again, if you don't have an NVIDIA card, make sure to check out that link below. I'll press enter again here to proceed with the installation. And if you went ahead and made it this far, please smash that like button for me. It really does help me out. Now we're starting to get to the exciting part. So we are going to clone down the repo with all the .dot files necessary for this XMonad setup. So we're going to use the following repo, and I'll post a link in the description below. Also, as you can see here on the repo, there's plenty of information on not only troubleshooting, but how to install both on Gentoo and Arch Linux. If you need something to follow along, make sure to check out Arva's wonderful repository page. And also, if you find issues, make sure to post them on the repo as well. One thing I will mention is that there are currently only two monitor setups available for the configuration, which are 1366 by 768 pixels and 1920 by 1080. You can, however, make edits to the configuration to support your native resolution. But for me, it works great because I have 1920 by 1080 here. Let's clone down the repo. So git space clone space https forward slash github.com capital A X A R V A. And then we want the dot files dash 2.0. That should clone things down. And we should have a new folder after things have successfully cloned. Let's write ls. Yep, dot files exists. Next, I will change directories into the dot files directory. Press enter. And now that I'm in here, I'll change the permissions on a specific shell script. So if I look here, the repo has supplied us with two various different types of installs, either on Gentoo or on Arch. This is Arch Linux, so of course that's the one we'll be using today. But this makes it much easier on us to, instead of having to install all the various different packages that are necessary for this XMonad setup, they're conveniently packaged into the shell script. You can check out the shell script if you open it up in a text editor or on the Git repo if you want to check things out. So let's make sure that the script is in fact executable. We'll do chmod space plus x space install on arch sh is the one we want. Press enter, no errors, so we're good. And now we will run the install on arch .sh script. If you still haven't already, smash that like button because we're moving on to the installation of this customized setup. All right, we'll type in ./ and then install on arch.sh. We'll press enter and we're welcomed first. We need a password to an administrative user in order to run the script. So I'll give my password and then press enter. Following that, there will be a few checks and then we're asked about graphic drivers and if we need to install any. Since we already talked about installation of graphics drivers, we can skip this step. So select number 3 for skip. If for some reason you haven't, you can select number 1 for Intel and number 2 for an AMD graphics card. All right, I'll press enter. And then the script will begin installing packages that it needs set up. This might take a few moments. So here we're asked whether we want to install Yay, which is the AUR helper. So we'll type yes if you don't already have it. This will be necessary to grab some of the packages that exist in the user repos and not in the default. So I'll type in yes and press enter. And next we're asked if we want to keep proceeding with the installation because there will be a few more packages installed. Go at this point, let's press enter. Now this might take a few moments as we're going through multiple installations. And here we're asked about installing the latest version of Yay. Yes, proceed with installation. And next we have a slew of other packages that we're going to need, including XMonad at the very end here. All right, we'll press yes again by hitting enter. And now we're grabbing a repo from the AUR, Yay. So we can select between one or two candy icons or candy icons-git. We want the second one, at least for me. The first one doesn't seem to be working anymore. At least I haven't had success using it. So I'll select 2 instead of the default 1 and press enter. Following that, we're asked if we want to remove the dependencies after the install. I'm going with the default no and enter. And here the default press enter is none. We'll press enter once more to get all these packages as well that are necessary. As we cruise through some of the Rafi setup and candy icons, we'll get a few messages, a few things cloned and generated as well. This is the bulk of setting up environment and installation, so it might take just a moment. And then we're asked whether we want to use the 1366 by 768 resolution or the 1920 by 1080. As I specified at the beginning, these are the two available currently. So I'll type in 2 and press enter for me. And then we are given a little bit of a note. This is also available on Git repo if you want to check it out. And we're asked, do we want to change our default shell? So I'm using bash right now, zsh. Yes, I do. It's necessary to get the full experience of this custom XMonad setup. So yes, so press enter. And we're asked for a password for administrative user. Put that in. And now we see that the shell was successfully changed over to sh. Oh my zsh. Perfect. So there are a few things that you can set up from the Git repo under the section called installation. So one thing we can set up is a cron tab that runs periodically in order to get the weather or get specific quotes whenever you log in after a reboot. I'll let you create the cron tab if you'd like. It's available on the GitHub page, but I'll skip that one because it's not necessary for me. I don't need the weather update or the quotes, so I'll skip that portion. But one that is important is we need to open up using your favorite text editor. So I'll use Vim for mine. And then in the home directory, we can put a tilde / .zsh .rc. That's the file we want. And with that opened up, let's make sure below this line here where it says export, we'll add another export capital path equals. Let's put our double quotes in, both opening and closing. And then a $ path, all capital, colon, forward slash, home, your username, SavvyNick for me, forward slash, bin. That way, the path variable has access to your home user bin directory. Next, save this and exit. And you can edit the script that's located, again, vim. We'll do the tilde for home. And then .config, eww, scripts, get weather. So if we look through here, we'll find get weather. And here we're given some instructions on how to actually update our weather information. I won't be setting this up, but notice that you can go to openweathermap.org and get an API and a city ID you want that set up for yourself. All right, it's fairly easy. You just put the key in here after you have one in the ID city second line here. Save and exit. And for now, I'll keep that off. The repo also suggests to install the Museo Sans 300 font. You can get this from Adobe if you really want it, but there are other options available, like the Iosveka Nerd font included with the repo that you can use instead. And in my opinion, it looks just as good, if not better. We're getting pretty close to finishing up, so make sure to smash that like button. And let's issue XMonad. XMonad space dash dash recompile to recompile things for the window manager. And we should see a XMonad recompilation process exited with success if everything went all right. And since we're using systemd instead of another system init package, we'll need to make sure to edit a file real quick. It's also mentioned in the repo, but let's go over to vim. We'll do bin forward slash power menu dot sh. Make sure that you're in your home folder in order to do this, or put a tilde forward slash so you can get to it properly. And in here, we want to make sure to search for anything called login CTL and change that over so it uses systemctl. So I'll just make an edit here, type in systemctl, write my changes, and just confirm that login CTL doesn't show up anywhere else. There are a few more occurrences of login CTL. I can also search for those occurrences in the home directory by doing rep cursively, and we can search for login TL. It doesn't look like any of these files are actually necessary according to script to change. They're not being used by this setup. You can reference the ones that do need to be changed. The only other thing I want to make sure is that do as replaced as well. And upon looking through here, the only place I see it is in the power menu script where it needs to be changed. So I will do that in there as well. So again, back to the bin power menu sh, we'll search for do as and change do as. So there's another occurrence right here. So I believe those are the only two files that we use in. I'll just confirm that there's no more do as instances. Not. I'll save and exit. And now we only have a couple more files to edit. That way we can start our X server properly and finally start XMonad. So I'll clear things out. And now I will edit a file. If I'm in the home user directory, I want to either create a new file or edit it. So vim.zprofile for zprofile. And in here, this is a new file, at least for me, since I just got done setting up ZSH and I haven't changes. I'll type in start X at the very top and save and exit out of this file. That's all I need here. That will help us launch the X server. And finally, let's create a xinitrc file. So we'll do vim.xinitrc, also here in the home user directory. Inside this file, we need to type in exec for execute space xmonad xmonad, and then we can save and exit this out of this file. One other thing I like doing is editing the font right away in my config alacrity.yml file. I like when my font is a bit bigger, so I'm going to do 12 font here, my size, save and exit out of this one as well. You could, of course, make more changes to Alacrity, but I would say do this after the fact. All right, and now if we've successfully done things, we can exit out of the user by typing exit a couple times and getting back to the original login screen where we can type in our username and our password to get back into the user where we were setting everything up on. And if things go well, what we'll be welcomed with is our brand new XMonad setup. Congratulations if you made it this far, successfully installed things here. And we have this beautiful setup. Again, special thanks to XArva for setting this up and spending the time developing the documentation and giving us such a beautiful setup. I've been using this for quite a while now, a couple months actually, and it's been great. There are a few little bugs, but you can look at the GitHub page to try fixing those, and you'll need to tweak things a little bit here. As we can tell right off the bat, the bottom bar isn't quite the size that I would personally like. Moreover, because there's not a lot of application icons down there to fill the space, but I'll show you how to make tiny tweaks and edits to this real quick in order to launch our very first terminal here and to get the appreciation of the Alacrity terminal here. We'll hit our super key, shift, and then enter. For me, the super key will be referenced as Windows from now on, the Windows key. So I'll type in the Windows key, shift, enter. And here is the wonderful Alacrity terminal. It looks amazing as well. The colors are really beautiful too. And what I'll type in is, since we're gonna launch the tint2 config in order to make edits to our panels, launchers, taskbars, we'll have to use config. We need one package, so I'm going to type in pacman space dash syu space gtk2, and it says I need to be root. I forgot about that. I'll just type in sudo !! That will rerun the last command with sudo, and then I'll type in my password to get this package. Finally, if I clear things out, let me make the font a little bigger so we can see better. All right, that should be a lot better. Again, all we ran was this sudo pacman syu gtk2 in order to get the K2 package. Now we can run the tint2 conf package, which will launch a new window over here on our left side. Of course, this is a window tiling manager, so things came up on the left here as a new window. And in this window, tint2 config will help us configure these various panels. We can see what's currently available here and what they currently look like. One I want to change right off the bat is this one at the bottom. I'll double click on that and we'll get a new window here, which allows us to have multiple tabs on the left side. One thing I'll suggest to go through is in the background, we can change this to the active taskbar, and we can also change the panel length to something more manageable here. What if we do 33% of the screen instead? I'll apply that. That looks much more manageable. We don't have to put as many icons in there. You can also change the size if you'd like. So let's say we want it to 50 pixels instead. Here we go. That looks a little better. The icon's a little bigger to see. A lot to play with here, so feel free to customize this as you wish. Make sure to share your setups with us on the Discord community. Join us. We're a very friendly bunch. And if we continue on to through some of these other ones, I'm really interested in the launcher where we can specify various applications that are launched, a bottom panel here. So if you want to remove some of these that exist in the past, as we can see, Firefox was defaulted down there, Spotify as well. You can remove them by hitting this arrow here, and then you can include whichever ones that you do want from over on the right hand side. So I have NVIDIA here, the settings, I'll throw the server settings in. And as you're gaining more and more packages and applications, you'll be able to pull those over from the right hand side into the left side. I'll go ahead and apply things here, and we can see we gained another icon at the very bottom. Those are all nice to know about. And now we've kind of had a primer on how to edit the panel at the bottom. You can edit any of these panels here. If I hit cancel, that'll take me back to the rest of the panels that are available. And if I hit window key shift C, that will close the current window and we'll get back to our main terminal window here. So there are many key bindings for this XMonad setup. Make sure to check them out on the GitHub page. There's a list of the most used ones. So the Windows key O launches the Rafi menu. And then if you hit escape, you can exit out of that. Windows Shift Q launches the power menu. Shift S launches the side menu. As you can tell, it looks absolutely stunning here. Windows P opens up the dashboard here. Windows Shift P closes the dashboard. Win B will get rid of all the various panels. If you want to toggle through the gaps, you can do it by Window Control G key. And a few other ones to note, Windows Shift Enter will create more terminals for you. And you can navigate through Windows with Win key J K or Win space to switch out the various different types of layouts available. I like using that one a lot. If we type in Win and then use the left mouse, we can move things around. And to get things back tiled and neatly, we Win T, which will tile them right back together. All right, and what I've brought up here is HTOP, just so we can see the current memory usage. There's 445 megabytes of 32 gigs being used up. 445 megabytes is quite low for an overall environment. That's, of course, since it's been up quite a while at this point, but you can reboot things in order to see, so you can see how minimal things really are. Make sure to put this beautiful custom setup to good use. Also, feel free to tinker around a little bit, make it your own, and make sure to think XArva below in the comment section. Well, that's about it. I hope you enjoyed things. This one's been a long time coming, but I wanted to get it right. And if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please make sure to post them in the comment section below. Also, make sure to subscribe for future videos and make sure to like the video. Catch me in a great community on Discord, and I'll catch you in another video. Thanks for watching.